These are the oil fields of West Texas. 2 miles beneath the dust and rattlesnakes lies a buried treasure that men are willing to risk their lives to get. 100% Texas crude.
She's gotta blow!
This is the ultimate race to strike it rich. And modern day cowboys are willing to dig deep.
You gotta keep it drilling, rain or shine, man!
Just for a taste.
Oh man, I live for this.
Of black gold.
Previously on Black Gold. As the three rigs closed in on the bottom of their first wells, the Longhorn got stuck.
This ain't gonna be no easy task.
But Gerald brought the hammer down and got them back to drilling. The big dog's hole is collapsing, and Justin's feeling the heat.
You get these problems like this, it's costing a lot of money and a lot of time. It's what we call a well from hell.
At the brand new Viking, Wayne and his crew fought through mechanical nightmares to get back in the race.
I hope everything goes just like it's happening right now. If it does, we'll be in good shape.
And now, they're on the Longhorn's tail.
Yeah.
I love this, buddy.
This week, one of these rigs will hit bottom, but will they strike oil? The hunt for black gold never stops in West Texas.
First down, good morning, America. Take them back, Henry.
On the veteran Longhorn rig, driller Gerald's cracking the whip on his roughnecks.
Come on, push your head of the tongs around.
The Longhorn crew has been digging this hole for 13 days, and now they're less than 2,000 feet from the pay zone.
Hit it out there, Peanut. Let's go.
These guys are so close to the bottom, they can smell the oil. But Gerald's veteran instincts tell him this drill bit won't get them to total depth.
We'll pull that bit here in a little while. It's pretty well worn. I mean, I can tell by the way it's drilling here. It's torquing up.
A damaged drill bit could get stuck in the hole and break off in the well. It has to be replaced, but changing the bit means pulling nearly 2 miles or 160,000 pounds of pipe out of the ground.
Welcome to the Friday morning. Rack 'em and stack 'em.
Roughnecks call it tripping pipe. It's dangerous, exhausting, time-consuming, and dirty.
Look at the bright side. I bet you ain't never done that much screwing in your life, man.
But it's something you have to expect in the oil field.
Get your tongs off. Get your mud bucket on it. Faster, Peanut.
Pulling all that pipe will cost the crew a day's worth of drilling and cost the boss, Mike LaMonica, close to $50,000.
Watch the top of that damn pipe. That dead man gonna kill you.
Gerald wants to get it done fast, safe, and clean.
Come here, both of you. One of you ought to be right there, and the other one ought to be right here. That's going to be your two dry sleeves. Does it come out that way?
Well, that's why you need to be over here so it don't get me, dumbass.
Clean for him, at least.
Get it out there. Let's go.
By daybreak, the Longhorns already pulled up nearly 1,000 feet of pipe.
Beautiful Texas sunrise!
Only 8,000 more to go, and it's going to be nasty.
Everybody watch out, it's gonna be wet. Get the hell out of there, Peanut. Go, 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 Peanut, go. That's what you call a mud bath, boys. Let's go to work.
Gerald and his roughnecks are going all out to keep their lead. But at the brand new Viking rig, Wayne and his crew know the Longhorn setback is just the break they need.
The old Longhorn rig, they're not drilling, so that gives us a chance to make up some ground.
There we go. We can buy. I got it. Don't worry, buddy. Don't worry about me.
Driller Wayne pushed his rig back into the race. They're only 500 feet behind the Longhorn, but they just drilled into a layer of hard rock.
We were cutting 90 foot an hour. We're down to about 20 foot an hour right now.
Wayne and his crew will have to cut through the hard rock to get to the bottom.
We're all kind of hoping this bit will make it all the way down to TD where we don't have to make another bit trip there.
Wayne wants the drill bit to turn faster, but he's happy with his crew, especially Junior.
Yep. Get ready for the next one.
That dude's a hell of a hand there. That's one of your better players on the team, you know.
Hold on here, Jesse!
Junior's just 22, but he's already a veteran of the oil field.
I've been doing this since I was 17 years old. It's just real exciting. It's dangerous. It just gets my blood pumping. It's just badass.
To him, the Viking rig isn't just a workplace. It's become home.
Old Junior there, he's looking for a family, you know, and I think he feels like he's found it out here on this rig.
He's a good kid, calls me Dad.
Hey, you want me to jump on there, Dad, so I can show him something? Can I jump on there?
Junior dropped out of high school to be a roughneck. Floorhand Steve has bigger plans.
9052, and that's our gradient. That's a big difference in between being a hand for the rest of your life and moving up and going on to bigger and better things is getting a grasp on the mat. Because it's cool to come out here and work and bust your ass, but nobody
wants to. When you see that, this is what you can get from roughnecking.
Yeah.
Right here.
Yeah. But all that don't mean a hill of beans, if you don't know that right there, Steve. Well, at least I think so.
Steve's not the only one watching the numbers. Back in Midland, the drilling costs for both Viking and Longhorn have the attention of Mike LaMonica and his partners at EXL Petroleum.
Okay, let's go through where we are. Let's start out with
Viking. It's going slow again. They had a project to be 20-day well, and I look at, we like another 5 days on this well.
EXL is already gambling millions on their rigs drilling three wells in 50 days. They can't afford more delays.
When we started this play, we're costing $600,000 to drill and complete. It got up to almost $2 million to drill and complete, so there's been an escalation of costs.
The company needs to hit oil soon. Mike's betting on the Longhorn.
It's got everything going for it that it should be a good well.
But his partners have their doubts.
Quantities of oil remains to be seen.
But there is no such thing as a sure thing.
I need to pick locations.
Back at the Viking, Wayne's still hoping his bit will hold out to total depth.
Well, that's probably a $40,000 bit we got in the hole there. This bit's screwed up there. It could cost the company a lot of money, you know. That sunbitch ought to be putting a rug there, man. It ought to be tearing it up.
The brand new rig's drilling data is all run through a state-of-the-art computer system. And on this rig, what the computer says goes.
I'm like a caveman when it comes to that computer stuff. But really, a majority of them, they're going to this computerized I guess I'll have to learn it.
The computer has bad news for Wayne. Whether he agrees or not, it's time to pull the drill bit.
That's kind of frustrating to get that close down there to TD and then have to make a bit drill. That's going to add almost another day to the whole length of the well there.
Just like the Longhorn, the Viking will now have to pull all their pipe out of the ground.
Okay. Right.
If Wayne and his crew get back to drilling first, they'll have a shot to take the lead. Pushing hard to plow through the bit change.
That's good, get off of it.
But working this fast is just asking for trouble.
Ooh. Yeah.
Junior is pulling more than his own weight. The 125-pound collar slips he's dragging should be a two-man job.
Ah!
body goes and I can't do this.
Junior might be done in the oil field. And later.
Here's boss.
It's my word.
Big dog driller Justin shows his rookie Derek some moves off the ring. At the brand new Viking rig, Wayne's crew is racing to pull nearly 2 miles of pipe out of the ground to get a look at their drill bit.
Coming out of the hole.
Whoa!
But Junior's just gone down.
Hey, I killed my back, dude.
It takes more than a hurt back to get a West Texas Roughneck off the rig. Junior is going to gut out the rest of his shift. The Viking crew is like a family. Steve gives Junior the lift he needs to finish the job.
Kicking ass, buddy.
There's that bit sub. Here it comes.
The nearly 2 mile trip is finally over, and the bit is out of the ground.
Right there, driller.
Old pro Wayne thought the bit could survive to the bottom of the hole. But the Viking's computer called for a change. New technology got this one right.
We done good pulling it like we did today. You can see on this bit right here, the diamond cutters were starting to wear all the way in the middle right here. Once you get a little chip on them and you keep drilling, then you start cutting into the diamonds on them. These bits right here, they'll cut a lot of, faster hole than the conventional bit. Hell, they'll double your penetration rate there, so they're high dollar, but they're worth it.
Once the bit's been changed, it's time for the crew to head home. No one's happier to leave than Junior.
This is some poor muscle. I should be fine when I wake up.
Hell yeah, it is time to go home. It's time to go home. Yeah.
Oh, what a day, what a day.
It's a new day in West Texas, and a new gamble for oil man Mike LaMonica.
Last time y'all finished.
All you have to have is 5 reds to have a clutch, right?
Yeah, well, you go ahead and try it here in a minute. We'll let you know.
I'm going to cut them, buddy.
He's hoping to take his pipe salesman, Rooster McConaughey, in a game of Texas Hold'em.
Well, I like them bent up there.
Yeah, they're out there. They're all bent up.
Yeah, I don't want y'all to see me. Nobody reads my eyes, Charlie Patrick. I'll tell you that right now. Burning one.
It's Mike's bet. Hold on. Mike, it's Mike's bet.
9 DNAs.
I'm out.
All right.
Good. You're out. All right.
Okay. And I'm good. All right.
Now Darren, you're here, y'all can see me.
Oil business is dang sure more risky than cards any day.
Except for the pipe business. The pipe business, there's no way you can lose.
Rooster knows better than to bite the hand that feeds him.
Oh my God.
I'm handicapped. I can beat him out of $200 and lose $200 million worth of thing business in the next 4 years. I gotta sit here and act like I gotta kiss his ass the whole time.
Yeah, you do.
You're not gonna what? You gutless bastard!
I'm gone.
You're gone.
I'm out.
Cut up. Got my Darth Vader hat here in a minute.
Now I know you can't
see. Yeah, I can see through that green glass.
I'm so happy. Yes, we are.
The fix is in at the card table, but there are no guarantees in the oil field. Steve and Bryson are on their way to another shift at the Viking.
Number one priority is making sure everybody gets home all right. If we do that, then we had a good day.
Yesterday wasn't a good day.
Whoa!
But as long as the oil field keeps offering big paydays, roughnecks will keep coming back to the rigs.
If I couldn't roughneck, I really wouldn't know what to do with myself.
Every day I have that anxious feeling, just
can't wait to get there and see what's going on.
Wow, I want to see if they got all that drill pipe out. And not, I won't have to finish it up.
On their last shift, the Viking crew pulled almost 2 miles of pipe out of the earth. Today, they have to finish putting it back in.
Try not to fall.
Look at you, driller.
No drilling the last 2 days has cost $90,000. And thrown the Viking even further behind schedule.
Get the hole.
Even worse for the crew, Junior's a no-show.
I don't know where the hell Junior is. He's supposed to be in here today, but he didn't show up. Left us kind of short-handed.
I don't know, man. He ain't here. Missing in action. Somebody's got to pick up the slack.
He didn't give me a call. And if I show up short-handed out here, that kind of puts my job on the line, too. Whoa,
but without Junior, the Viking crew is struggling to get the pipe back in the ground.
We probably won't make it all the way back in, especially at this rate.
All day long, buddy.
Junior's missed day puts Wayne in a tough spot.
I'm a real forgiving guy. I want to see Junior make it. If he can't make it, then that's his bad, you know. He's going to miss out on a good job.
While Viking struggles to pick up Junior slack, the giant big dog is far behind their competitors, and driller Justin's got all he can handle.
I'm getting hung up, man.
They haven't drilled in 7 days, and 500 feet of their hole has already collapsed.
Some wells you could drill are just a nightmare. It's what we call a well from hell.
At a depth of 6,000 feet, they're 2,000 feet behind Viking and 2,500 behind the Longhorn. But their luck might be changing.
Yeah, we're going to make a connection.
It looks like they can finally start drilling again.
Hopefully we'll have a good clean hole coming up. We'll be able to make this connection. Come back down, tag bottom. It's looking good so far.
With the drill bit turning, Justin assigns the rig's worm, Derek, to catch up on some overdue cleaning.
I want it clean. All this clean. I'm going to leave it there.
Driller talking telling me to clean this stuff up. Like, nah, man, I'm just going to leave it. Like, yeah, I'm just going to leave it. Got to talk a little bit every now and then. Can't let him run all over you all the time.
Yeah, as far as Derek, I see him moving up, but as long as he keeps his head out of his ass and he can keep his act straight and quit arguing with me.
Derek's got a habit of talking back, but he knows Justin's giving him a great opportunity.
I'm glad to be trying to learn some more things, you know, work my way up to drilling someday. That's what everybody wants, you know, get that gravy train.
If Derek wants to move up on this rig, he'll have to start by climbing it.
You gotta watch your balls, man. If your jewels get in the wrong spot, point.
Scrubbing the rig might sound simple, but Derek knows one mistake could prove fatal.
Met a guy on I think it was a big dog rig. He was doing the same thing I'm about to do, and he wasn't doing his ABC. Always be careful. Somebody wasn't watching. His airways got caught in the galley. Spun him up and wrapped him and killed him. Your life's on the line every day.
It won't take long, man, about 4 hours. All right? I want you to stay on it. I'm serious, stay on it. Get that done, dude. You do that for me today, dude, and I'll take you out and buy you a couple beers, all right, man?
Justin knows that with a 1,000-horsepower motor turning the drill bit, the worm won't stand a chance if he gets caught in the wrong spot.
A lot of people, you got a lot of loose things hanging around. That wrap up in the Kelly. You're done for, you know, it'll take you in and kill you. He's just scared of all the stories that are going around, you know.
On a drilling rig, scrubbing's more than busy work. The rig tower supports 175,000 pounds of pipe. The crew's safety depends on the integrity of the iron Derek is cleaning. As drilling continues, Justin keeps one eye on the rig floor and the other on the worm above. He suddenly notices that Derek's in trouble.
Hey! Pull your line out of the way! Pull the air hoist line out of the way!
Coming up.
That right there is the bit, gentlemen.
The Longhorn gets the drill bit out, but they can't believe what they find. And Wayne faces an agonizing decision.
Just because Junior come back today, it don't necessarily mean that he's got a secure job.
Out at the giant Big Dog, the worm Derek is learning the hard way that it's not easy to move up in the oil field. He's been scrubbing the rig for over 5 hours.
A good hand can do it in 4 hours. I don't think you'll get it done, really, I know.
He's just wanting to kind of half ass it.
I think he'll be buying me some beers tonight. Hurry up!
As his shift comes to an end, Derek returns to the rig floor in one piece.
Definitely glad to be down.
But just as driller Justin predicted, the worm couldn't get the job done.
I tried to make a good run, and I think it looks okay. I wouldn't eat off of it, that's for sure.
That means Derek's picking up the tab tonight.
I'm gonna head to the bar, see what I do with some women. I'm gonna buy my boss a few beers.
The rig isn't the only place Justin shows Derek how it's done.
Oh,
what do y'all do?
Yeah, we work in a drilling rig.
My company.
Big Dog Drilling.
That's cool.
It's not bad, man. It's work. It pays good.
We have different sauces. Which one would you like?
What's the best?
Mild,
you
medium.
Recommend the best.
Are you a pansy? Can you handle
it? No, I'm not a pansy.
Do you want a side of our hottest sauce?
Yeah.
Bentley?
Yes, ma'am.
Sure you can handle it.
Yes, ma'am.
All right, I'll be right back.
Thank you.
Hey, dude, I think she was kind of like
pretty good girl.
I think she's single.
We're supposed to have a badass pool party tomorrow.
Oh, really? I'll try to get some of the girls to come out there.
Hey, see what you can do, man. It'll be a good time.
Looks like Justin and Derek are going to have a day off to remember.
Hooters girls and a pool party?
The next morning on the veteran Longhorn rig.
Dope it.
The crew is about to finish pulling almost 2 miles of pipe out of the ground to change the drill bit. They're only 2,000 feet from bottom, but Gerald's experience told him the bit wasn't going to make it.
We'll get to go ahead and pull that bit here in a little while. It's torquing up, it's giving me a lot of trouble.
For Gerald's exhausted crew, one mistake with this much iron could have quick and painful consequences.
Yeah, you damn sure don't want to get your toe under that pipe when it comes down. It'll all be over with but the time. And I can verify that if you let one of them land on your big toe, you won't have a big toe. I know, I don't have one. Got three more stands of pipe plus two singles and then all the drill collars. So, we don't like much.
The drill collars are extra thick pipes that add weight on the bit. They're also the biggest challenge when tripping pipe.
Hold on, don't get mad, just hang on. All right, get him off. That boy will be dealing with about 10,000 pounds once we turn it loose on him.
All right, this is the hard one.
There's two of you, one on each end. Wait a minute.
Finally, 8,500 feet of pipe is out of the ground.
That right there is the bit, gentlemen.
But the veteran driller is in for a surprise.
Could have drilled another couple days on that one.
It ain't hurt. It ain't hurt, man. We're gonna change it. But it's not totally wore out. I mean, it's wore, but it's not wore out.
That bit is good. They could have drilled longer.
Right, that bit's good.
Who pulled the bit? Who made the call? Wrong call.
Pulling the bit early cost Mike LaMonica close to $50,000, and it could cost the Longhorn the race.
How deep's that other rig over there now?
The day's only getting worse for Henry. Now he has to lug the 125-pound replacement bit up to the rig floor.
This peanut stuff. I think he weighs more peanut does, though.
Is it heavy enough? Damn.
Well, so there comes our new bit there. Henry's uncrating it now. And we'll get this old one off there, get that new one on here. We got two slots on each side out here. We're gonna take that chunk of metal right there, we're gonna slide it over here, which will make this a square then. Then I can put it in my rotary table, then I can break it out. There you go. All right, catch that Totco. Don't let it bend my Totco. Get that bit off the floor. See if you can find us another bucket of dough, Bubba. This bit should finish the hole. We should be able to finish the hole up with this one right here.
The bit is changed, but now they have to get all that pipe in the ground before they get back to drilling. At the Viking, Wayne's crew has their pipe back in the ground, and they're drilling again. And the team's back at full strength. Junior's returned after his no-show yesterday.
I ain't like 100% right now, but at least I'm here, though. Rough deck is a different kind of lifestyle, it's a different kind of work. I mean, you're being paid good money if they expect you to be here.
Junior hasn't talked to Wayne about missing work yet, and the driller is quickly losing faith in his favorite roughneck.
You can watch him walk around now. It looks like he's got a corn cob up his ass or something.
Just because Junior come back today, it don't necessarily mean that he's got a secure job.
I'll be all right, though.
Can't be Superman all the time.
They know they got a job to do when they come out here. If they can't do it, then they had to go find them a new job.
Coming up, it's Roughnecks Gone Wild.
We share that's the rig right now.
Put the ranch against the floor.
And Gerald lays down the law with his crew.
Chain these son of a bitches off and get him out of my way.
The brand new Viking is back to drilling. They're a day behind the veteran Longhorn in the race to the bottom. But Wayne's focus is on the situation with Junior. He needs to know if he can depend on his young roughneck.
We need to have that talk with old Junior because I just hate to see him get to where he gets down so far that I have to jet his ass, you know, because if he's out here not making a hand and stuff, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to run that ass off. I hate to do it because he's a good kid and stuff, but he's got to come out here and do his job, too. Everybody knows your back kind of bothering you, but you don't seem like yourself, man.
I'm fine, though.
You all right?
Yeah. Just sore a little bit, that's all.
You know, when you first started, man, I'll tell you what, I thought you was my best hand that I had. And I really, I don't know now, man. You all right?
Yeah.
Wow. If something's wrong, you know, you can tell me because the old pop will listen to you.
Yeah, I know.
I don't want Junior taking mine and his relationship for granted. They're like, we're supposed to be all buddy-buddy and stuff. He's got to come out here and he's got to do his job, and he needs to. I don't want him bringing everybody else down.
See, you're going to hurt yourself again, man.
I just got a twisted pain, that's all.
While Wayne is hoping Junior can turn things around, the crew of the massive Big Dog finally has things going in the right direction. Over the last 3 days, Big Dog's drilled more than both Longhorn and Viking. The crew can finally relax and have some fun at the expense of their worm.
That old worm still ain't noticed he got that thing on his head.
Hey, Derek, how much rain we get today? Rain. Yeah, that rain gauge you got going on. Well, you know how much rain you got caught in there yet?
What rain gauge?
You don't know about that rain gauge?
No.
But when you figure it out, let me know.
Dude, what the f***? Oh, did you?
Getting the Big Dog back on track has been hard work for Derek and Justin. But with the afternoon off,
salute.
Hard work turns to hard play.
Could be busting our ass. Exactly right now, going into work.
I don't know what to do with myself, man.
Come hang out with the Hooters girl.
Yeah, got to.
I got this tent and I was pretty drunk. I thought it was cool. That's what I was intending. That's what I was intending. Very sexual, ma'am.
Ma'am? I like the ma'am. You're his boss?
Ma'am, fire me. It's my worm. I'm number one worm.
Number one?
Number one worm.
Great old town of Odessa, Texas.
You're shit, man. You got the way you got it all, brother.
While the Big Dog crew enjoys the afternoon off, Longhorn's having trouble getting started again.
Give me a hammer or something to hold this motherfucker down.
Just as they're ready to go back in the hole with a new drill bit, their clutch gives out.
Rena, put the wrench against the floor.
After pulling almost 2 miles of pipe to swap a still-working drill bit...
That bit is good. It could have drilled longer.
Right, that bit's good.
Gerald knows the other rigs are gaining on him.
Anytime you got to stop the mechanic on something, eats up your time you can be making footage.
Gerald's feeling the pressure to get this well finished, but the more he barks orders...
Cover that hole up!
...the less his crew responds.
I got all these bosses telling me how to do it. I got people pulling tongs in on top of me. Get that damn air horse off of there. Chain these son of a bitches off and get them out of my way. I don't care if you get them out. You're pulling them in to me.
Run your for all you want. I really don't give a.
You know, the last account I had, I told three hands, get over here, get these guards off. I don't see a damn one of them over here. All these hands, you give them some little something, they'll with it all day long. Can hold up $1 million show over a damn $20 bill, you know.
Up next.
Get out of there, Kelly boy!
Man.
The Viking crew is coming on strong.
Oh man, I know you got it in you.
And the Longhorn crew fears the worst, a dry hole.
That's just old black sail. Ain't nothing in it today.
The veteran Longhorn rig has lost 2 days of drilling to tripping pipe and fixing the rig's clutch.
Let me show you how an amateur does it.
But now, driller Gerald is finally getting pipe in the ground again.
Oh, come on, Henry.
Like a worm.
Let's go. Open up my show.
The Longhorns' problems have jeopardized their lead. But even with the Big Dog and Viking narrowing the gap, the old rig's back on its game and closing in on the pay zone.
Let's go to work!
With any luck, that'll mean a big oil strike for Mike LaMonica and EXL.
If we strike oil, that man's going to dig more holes. That man digs more holes, this rig gets more work. This rig gets more work, I get work every day. This rig don't have work, that means I go to the unemployment line. And I don't like that idea. So I want them to hit good holes.
The Longhorns drilling in unproven territory. They have no idea if they'll hit oil.
From what I understand, they're wildcatting. They don't know for sure what's out here. This could be $1 million water well. I've seen that happen before.
We'll see what we come up with.
This close to the bottom, there should be traces of black gold in the hole. Gerald's going to use an old oil field trick to test the well.
I've checked samples for 30-something years now. I'll smell it or taste it. I can pretty well tell you if there's oil or gas there. We'll warm it up a little bit, see if we can get it to release any smell or anything. Smells like dirt. Looks like dirt. Damn, it must be dirt.
If there's no oil in the hole, this is $1 million bust for Mike LaMonica.
That's just old black sail. Ain't nothing in it today. Just stay there, guys.
A dry hole would be a huge blow to the Longhorn, but their rivals at the Viking are in high spirits. And with Junior back on the rig, they're in high gear as well.
Woo!
I like to see the old Junior back on the floor, man.
Good to see you.
One more time, Junior.
You all right?
Pulled pretty hard. Like, this is my life, man. I wanted to do this when I was 15 years old.
Junior's back with the full force, man. I'm glad to see that. He's a lifesaver, I'll tell you.
I'm a bad mother. I know it, boy. I know I am. That's what's scary.
You do good, man.
Coming up.
We're just damn near the bottom.
The race for black gold comes down to the wire.
Hey, hurry the up.
And Mike LaMonica finds out if his $1 million gamble's gone bust.
Yeah, this does not look good.
At the veteran Longhorn rig,
we're just damn near the bottom. We'll TD today.
Gerald and his crew are closing in on total depth. It's been a battle to get the drill bit 2 miles into the earth. They had to work a man down.
You better be pleased or I'm killing your ass.
They almost lost the well.
This ain't gonna be no easy task.
And Gerald pushed his crew to the edge.
Get that damn air horse off of there. Chain these son of a bitches off and get them out of my way. I don't care if you get them out. You're pulling them into me.
Now, it's the last push to hit the pay zone on their first well. There's only one more pipe to get in the ground. before hopefully striking black gold.
Come on, big guy. One more time, guys. Are we ready? Coming down.
It looks like we beat them. They tried real hard, but we're just a little bit better now, I guess.
They don't know if there's oil at the bottom, but getting there first gives the Longhorn crew bragging rights for now.
Everybody wants to think they're the best driller, and you want to talk crap, you better be ready to back it up.
I think Viking's still over there drilling, aren't they?
Yeah, we beat them.
While the Longhorn gloats at the brand new Viking rig, the loss is a bitter pill to swallow.
I feel like I got my ass whooped today, but we ain't gonna make it to the TD point. One of them deals, we did the best we could do, you know.
But Wayne's team knows this is far from over. Each rig has 3 wells to drill in 50 days, and the Viking crew is sure they'll still come out on top.
We lost the little battle there with the Longhorn rig right down the road here. They won this battle, but I think inevitably we're going to win the big war there, so
I guarantee you we will.
Longhorns won this round. And tonight, they're celebrating with a few rounds of their own. Mike LaMonica's not celebrating yet. His company is risking millions in unproven territory, and he needs the Longhorn to come in big. Today, it's the moment of truth. They will log the well. That means testing to see if there is any oil at the bottom of the hole.
So what I'm doing right now, if you look up on the screen, this side of the is what's called porosity. Porosity means just holes. All it is holes in rock. The more holes there are, the bigger the holes, the more oil there is. This is awesome right now. This is very, very good. That right there could make 50,000 barrels of oil. By itself.
So if this well turns into what I think it's going to turn in, this is going to be a heck of a well. Maybe 500,000 barrels, and it could be a phenomenal well. It will certainly make us, you know, kick us into another tier, another type of oil company.
Hey, guess what? We got a heck of a well.
Next time on Black Gold.
Whoa, whoa!
Can the Viking rig finish their first hole, or will new problems cost them the well and their jobs?
Pull that mother!
Will the Big Dog crew fall apart under the stress of the well from hell?
I had a little faith in somebody.
Let go!
That faith is gone now. Damn, man.
And can the Longhorn survive the move to their second well?
Motherfucker!